The revised lockdown measures of the state of emergency has relaxed some stringent provisions while also providing more clarity about the regulations. After the complete closure of almost all small and informal businesses, this sector has now been given a possible breather.
For us, an important amendment is the fact that we opened up the space for informal trading and open markets. And I think that's an important change for us.
We shall go ahead, open up these areas. However, we shall put certain health protocols in place to ensure that when that sector is opened up, people are managed in terms of the regulations, how to go there, how to conduct the activities there, those who shall be allowed to trade, and the customers in terms of social distancing, in terms of sanitation, and in terms of also other health measures that shall be required to mitigate the impact or the contamination or the transmission of COVID.
The education sector was also severely affected after the total shutdown included primary schools up to tertiary institutions. Education has now been declared as one of the essential sector too.
We've added education as a critical service. It wasn't there previously. And we've opened up the provisions on educational materials, which is important because if you're talking about closing schools and opening up the space for e-learning, it was important then for us to make provision in the regulations for those kinds of arrangements, because then it gives latitude to the state under the governance of the Minister of Education, but also governing bodies of various schools, including private schools, I suppose, to make the arrangements that they need to make for us to continue the teaching and learning process in Namibia.
The alcohol and liquor industry still remains a contentious issue.
The intention of these regulations are not really to punish people. That's not the intention. The intention is really to control certain activities during the state of emergency, and particularly during the period that is stipulated in this case, during the lockdown period, as to which activities people can engage in and which activities people cannot engage in. So, therefore, the issue about the 2,000, that's actually the impact, that's the maximum amount that should be imposed. But should you then be found guilty, it can be either 2,000 plus, 6 months imprisonment.
Rules on public gatherings unfortunately remain intact, and people have to observe the social distancing protocol, whether at funerals, at shopping malls, or when jogging.
The issues of, moving people to go outside, for example, to go to the shops or to go to the pharmacy or to go and exercise, there are limitations there that are put in the regulations for good reasons. And it is our feeling that the number that is stipulated are quite reasonable.
We do encourage Namibians to when they exercise with other family members. There is a reason why we have restrictions and confinement to residences, because we want people to generally be around their own family members. So and also I encourage Namibians to do any exercise within their neighborhoods, so that we avoid people congregating and so on.
The country has further been clustered in 10 zones with 69 security checkpoints to regulate and control people's movements. At the same time, the Minister of Health and Social Services says its surveillance and call centers are working effectively, and the public is urged to make use of such services. Jephthah Shihumino, NBC News, Windhoek.